moving on. It's time to get on with the exhaust. Now, I'm not happy with the noise the Porsche is making when I start the car. What I can hear is the exhaust smacking against the inside of the transmission tunnel. Now, it's not particularly dangerous and it's not going to cause much damage, but it is a major annoyance and it could lose us the potential sale, so I'm going to have to fix it. The exhaust is something which is very awkward to work on unless you've got a ramp. Because it's really dirty and rusty under here, it's well worth wearing a pair of goggles if you've got them. I've had a good look at the exhaust system and it turns out the last half is practically brand new. Now, I think what's happened is when they fitted it, they just rushed the job at the end. And what's happened here is the silencer is actually hitting on the bodywork. Now, of course, you don't want your exhaust to touch the car anywhere, which is why it's isolated with rubber bushes. Now, all I'm going to need to do is move this back by about 5 millimetres and I think the problem will be solved. What I'm going to do here is undo the exhaust U-bolt and the rear one, which holds the back box on, and then I'm going to just nudge the whole exhaust backwards a bit. And now for my adjusting tool. It might seem pretty severe knocking the exhaust around like this, but it's the only way to move it, and it won't be getting damaged while I'm doing this either. I think that's it. Well, there's no sign now of anything touching anything else, which it shouldn't. All I have to do now is do up the bolts. Cool. I said I was going to change these centre caps. Well, the reason for that is that this colour doesn't really complement the rim, but also doesn't really look very good with the black. So quite simply, I'm just going to pull them off and spray them a nice satin black. I think they're going to look really good after that. A new set would have cost £60, but a splash of red primer, some satin black, and we'll be sorted. I'm hoping all this care and attention will result in a big profit. For a Porsche 911 to command top money, it must be perfect in every detail. There's something significant missing from this picture, and that is our wing mirror. Now, it's going to sit around here, but before I can start putting this onto the door, I need to attend to this vandalism. Somebody in the past has tried to fit a mirror that clearly wasn't standard. They put some raw plugs in here with a bit of araldite. Now, I'm going to have to just rip that out, but luckily, four of the other holes are supposed to be there. That's how you fit a standard mirror. I reckon this is going to be quite an easy job. The previous owner supplied a set of mirrors with the car, but they weren't the originals. We bought these from a 911 specialist, and it was £95 well spent. Nobody will ever know the horrors that lurk beneath. We've bought a new long number plate to match our slimline bumper overriders and to replace the old US-style square plate. It costs £13 and gives the car a fresh look. A few easy fixes have transformed the look of our car. Mike complained about a dodgy handbrake on this Porsche, and that would normally lead me to look for either stretched handbrake cables or perhaps bad adjustment on the shoes inside the drum. Now, my instinct tells me it's neither of those, because this handbrake handle is clearly broken. I'm going to need a 13mm spanner to undo the two bolts that hold the handbrake handle onto the car. Once I've removed these, I should be able to pull the whole handbrake mechanism out from the car. Well, there it is. Now, you can see that somebody's had a really bad go at trying to fix this, and it's all mangled and mashed up and stuff. Now, they only cost about 15 quid from a breakers, so I might as well just get another one and replace it rather than trying to fix this one again. Well, this is our new one, and here's the old one, and you can see there's no damage on this side. It's not mangled or mashed. It's just all fine. So I'm going to put that one back in. Now, when I was taking this apart, I noticed that the handbrake light switch, just here, is actually broken. And very handily, they're the same as a Volkswagen van. So all I have to do now is just replace that. And then when the handbrake's up, the little light on the dashboard will work. Now, of course, when I put the handbrake back in, I need to remember to put this little hook back into the cable carrier of the handbrake. Jobs like these don't seem very exciting, but the handbrake is an essential safety requirement. It has also been a cheap fix for me. If the cable had gone or the drums weren't functioning, I would need to spend far more than 15 quid. Well, that's definitely working. And now I've even got lights on the dashboard too.
More or less any old car that has been standing will need attention to the brakes, but let's hope that this time the whole system isn't shot. That could be very expensive.
I can get a reasonable view of the brakes from here, but actually what I'm going to do is take them all apart so I can have a really good thorough look. I'm going to start with the caliper. Well, here's the front caliper off our Porsche. So I'm just going to take the pads out to get a better look at the caliper. There's a couple of pins here. Okay. Now, when I had to get this off the car, I had to kind of wiggle it around a bit to try and push the piston back inside the caliper, and it was actually very sticky, which is not a good sign. It should sort of flow, you know, a bit of resistance, but it should flow back reasonably well. And you can see there's quite a bit of corrosion around the outside of the piston, but also the dust cover has really, really perished, which is not a good sign either. So I think really, for peace of mind, I'm just going to replace this with a reconditioned unit.
The pads look fine, but they are cheap, so we will replace them. And good news, the discs aren't pitted and are pretty good. Rather than spend around £40 a corner, we'll keep using these.
Okay, you ready, Paul?
I'm ready.
Cool, cool. Okay, right, now push right down.
Down.
Okay. Okay, and then up.
Up.
And then down again.
Down.
Is that a good pedal?
Yeah, it's getting firm. Yeah, it's pretty good.
Wicked. Okay, I think we'll do that. That's cool.
And with the air definitely out of the system, just tighten the nipple and that's it.
Now, I thought that the brakes were going to be absolutely appalling on this, but on this corner alone, we only had to do the caliper and the pads. Now, if the rest of the car lets us off that lightly, we have got a right result.
I've just popped the bonnet to have a good look at the engine, and everything seems in really good condition. Mike's told me it recently had its cam belt changed, but is not sure when its last service was. So I'm going to give it a really quick service by changing the oil, some filters, and the spark plugs, just to be safe. Before I start anything else on the service, I tend to drain the oil. Draining the oil is a messy job and takes quite a while, so while it's draining out, I can sort out the air filter. Well, it's not too dirty, but it's worth changing now it's out. So I'll just get rid of that. If an air cleaner gets really dirty, it can restrict the airflow into the engine. This affects the air-fuel mixture, which can make the car run really badly. A light service like this will cost around £100 from a garage, so it's well worth having a go at it yourself. Now I'm going to change over the plugs. There's four of them, they're down here, and they're a long way away from my hands. This may seem pretty obvious, but you don't want to do this when the car is hot. You'll probably burn yourself, and you also run the risk of over-tightening the spark plugs. When you put a spark plug back into the head, make sure you don't cross the threads. When you buy a new spark plug, chances are the gap is actually already set correctly. But to be absolutely sure, you need to measure it with a special gauge. Now, on a Porsche, the gap needs to be between about 0.7 and 0.8 millimetres. Now, if you're not sure of the gap, it's worth checking in a manual. Now, that seems fine, so I'm going to put it straight back in the engine. Anyone who likes fiddling with cars can do this. It's just a bit oily and a bit fiddly.
Could do with a little more room, I think. OK, that's the spark plugs done, so now I'm going to change the dizzy cap and the rotor arm. To be fair, this rotor arm isn't in very bad nick at all. But again, they're so cheap, it's worth changing.
You don't need to get a rotor arm from Porsche. I got this one from a local auto store for about £7.
Now for the distributor cap. Now, if you look closely, on the outside it looks reasonably new, but on the inside you can see loads of corrosion on all the terminals, whereas on this one, it's all shiny. So again, it's so cheap, it's worth changing. As with the spark plugs, you want to make sure you get the right leads onto the right plug. And so here, you want to get the right lead onto the right terminal.
All done. Altogether, I've spent less than £50, but it'll make the car start and run better. Well worth it.
Click here to subscribe.